everybody, this is the M-Crew Dude. So after seeing a handful of new trailers and banners on YouTube Premium, there were a couple of interesting ones that caught my eye. While I was looking for something new, I came across Origin, created by Mika Watkins. Origin is a futuristic sci-fi series set aboard a large space station simply called the Origin, and at first, I was unsure of how this could hold for an entire 10-episode series, but luckily they found a way. The show centers around a group of people who wake up on board the Origin who were left behind after a sudden evacuation. You see, before that, an organization called Siren has given each member a chance to start a new life and leave their past behind while traveling to a distant planet called Thea for some kind of colonization experiment. We are given a good amount of time to be introduced to almost every character over the course of the series, and we get a lot of character building moments as their relationships are built with reluctant partnerships and initial distrust. Things get even worse when the passengers discover a new area of the ship and find a few injured crew members, while one is infected with an intelligent alien parasite that can take over a host's body and mimic their behavior to an almost human level. The alien then possesses one of the passengers and then jumps to someone else before the possessed person dies. Over the course of the show, the surviving passengers struggle to determine who is infected and who is telling the truth. This is a rather interesting setup, but unfortunately, Origin isn't very original, as it proudly showcases its inspirations with works such as Blade Runner, Alien, and Lost. In fact, the whole show is quite similar to Lost, but in space. Wait. Throughout the show, we get a series of flashbacks that center around most of the characters, and I found a lot of them to be very intriguing, while others were unexciting and raised more questions. Some of the primary characters that we focus on include a former Yakuza member named Shun, played by Sen Mitsuchi, a former bodyguard named Lana, played by Natalia Tena, a jewel thief named Bomb, played by Philip Christopher, a surgeon named Henri, played by Fraser James, and an arrogant delinquent with a heart of gold named Logan, played by Tom Felton. That's just naming the basic few, but there are a few more characters that receive even less screen time to be interesting, which is a shame because I was hoping to receive more context for some of the characters, as some of them don't even get a flashback. Hell, we spend 2 episodes exploring Shun's life, and that's not a bad thing, he's actually one of my favorite characters, but we focus more on some elements when I feel like time could be best allotted focusing on other story arcs. The flashback scenes are actually fun, and often take unexpected turns, so we do get a chance to make connections with some of the characters. With that said, there is also a lot wrong with the show. There are a few characters who never get any sort of flashback or background, like I said, which leaves some questions unanswered. There are also numerous plot holes throughout where characters could give information or find a clue that could solve the mystery right then and there. Of course they don't in order to keep the series going, but looking back in hindsight, a lot of the things that the characters do don't make much sense. One of the most annoying issues I have is that the show relies too heavily on jump startles. When done right, it can be very effective, but here, they do it so often and needlessly that it just comes across as predictable and lazy. The formula is also the same. Things go quiet, tension builds, and then someone jumps out or something goes bang. There's even an episode where they pull this crap 3 times. I already can't stand being jump-startled, but it's even worse when I see it coming, if that makes sense. The futuristic technology seen in the flashbacks was also intriguing, with a lot of really cool themes, such as these sort of android-like companions that I guess are designed to provide social interaction. I'm not sure if they're intended to be social therapists, sex workers, or hired friends, but it was an element that I wanted to see more of. At times, I feel like this show suffers from the same problems that Sherwood had, where it has a great world to explore, but it doesn't take a lot of initiative to explore it. But unlike Sherwood, Origin is relatively grounded in the real world, so it's much more identifiable. Season 1 is a binge-worthy ride, but I was actually pleasantly surprised at times. Unfortunately, YouTube has canceled any further seasons, which is a shame because there was a great setup for new adventures. Unfortunately, we may never get any sort of closure or answers, but I will say that despite its flaws, Origin is a pretty good show that's worth checking out. This is the M-Crew Dude, signing off, wishing you all a very pleasant day.